So that was the old entrance to RAF Locking. The guardhouse was on the left. And now that just leads you on to some of the new houses. I'm going to turn right up here, hopefully, if I can, although I'm not sure if I can. Yeah, should be able to. Go down there. So this is all a temporary road at the moment, while they're building the houses and building the proper road just over there. But it gives access to the current in-use houses. Just trying to grab my bearings. So different to how it used to be. Oh, actually, no, I know where I am. There's tennis courts here. The band hut was there. Right, so that's diverted traffic. I suspect this road's going to be closed off then. Yeah, so I'll turn it around. So yeah, the band house used to be there. With the RAF band of the southwest. Gravel. That's going to be an amazing ramp if that's what it is. And now we're going on to Oxford Square, which is the married quarter house that I used to live in, which is actually one way, and she's going very much the wrong way. It's amazing what some porches and flowers can do, because this was all very plain. Very military, obviously. And my house was just there behind that silver mareva. Road's open. Let's have a little drive down there, because it looks like that's the school. So I think this is the school, which is very nice. Now this whole area here and down there used to be one big car park with garages on. And where the school is now used to be the hangars that were held, or there to hold the vehicles I used to work on. So I don't think I'm allowed to go any further than this, but it is open. Right, so that road's going to go down across where my old workplace used to be. And back in the day, in the heyday of spring and summer, that road straight down there was lined with cherry blossom trees, really pretty, immaculate. And now it's all very much actually nice to see, allowing nature to take hold of it a little bit. And all being worked on. very pleasant. Okay, so let's spin around him, even Luigi. And make our way back. I hope this hasn't been too boring for you. I just wanted to come and have a look round to see what it was like, to see what the work was like and how much is changing. Well, pretty much everything's changing, but for the better. Okay, so thanks for staying with me. As always, I massively appreciate your time. Time's the one thing we can't get more of. Use it wisely. I'm almost talking you out of watching any of my vlogs now, aren't I? Because watching the toss that I put out is not using your time wisely, but hey, if it entertains you, it's done its bit. If at any point you laugh at me, the fact that I've made someone happy is what counts. Gonna do a random shout out. Now, which channel shall I shout out? There are so many of them. You see, when I subscribe to a channel, I don't unsubscribe. There is this feeling there amongst them. Other motor vloggers that are far more seasoned and secure than my channel, that people sort of throw you in a subscription to get you to subscribe back and then they unsubscribe. I don't do that. When I go into YouTube and I look at my subscription channels to see how many videos I've got to catch up on, it's a nightmare, but I enjoy it. I enjoy watching people's videos. I enjoy watching different places, learning different accents, and listening to different accents. But I still haven't decided who to give a shout out. I've done so many recently. That is a splendid paint job. I like that. That's good. I'm going to give a shout out to the Blue Bike and Doyle. He's a chilled out guy. Vlogs around his local area, very similar to me, does a few trips out. But he's a nice guy. So go over and give him a look, give him a sub, give him a like. It's all about support, and the MotoVlog community is one of the most supportive that I could possibly have imagined. It's not easy for the new channels to get into this, and that's not because, you know, people don't want new channels coming in and they want people to, you know, allow the big boys to continue with the monopoly. It's just hard because there is so many MotoVloggers out there that you're fighting for airtime, you're fighting for people's time sat in front of the TV, which, as I've said, is very precious these days. And that's why I do appreciate every single view, every single like, every single comment, and every single subscription. But go over and see Blue Bike and Doyle. Take care, guys. Have a good one. Stay safe. And I'll catch you on the flip side.